What's up, guys? Today I'm gonna be doing a video following up on my drone. And today we're gonna be making a case, so an actual way to carry this thing without it being a hassle. So, I mean, you go and buy an expensive drone, and trust me, they are really expensive. And then they want you to blow $100 to $200 or even $300 on just a bag to carry it. And I'm not gonna do that. But instead, I'm going to try to make a homemade Phantom case. Alright, so let's get started. Okay, so I got two options, two bags. I have an actual suitcase, which is Plan B. And then I've got a Samsonite bag, which is Plan A. So we're going to start with the Samsonite bag. Here it is. The reason I like this bag more is because it's more like tech related, and it's got like much more like pockets. And also the main reason, it still has straps plus wheels on it, so it makes it ideal for carrying. Now the problem is with this bag is that it might be too small for it, but we're gonna convert it so that it should be bigger. So all you need is a bag like this, or a suitcase, whichever you prefer, and then make sure to keep your box, because in the box, I actually thought about everything before I bought the drone, so I'm just sharing it with you guys. In the box is this cardboard thing, and don't need the box anymore. This is basically the layout, because that's really like the hardest thing to get, which is like the layout. And keep the top if you prefer. I think I'm gonna keep it, and then maybe work something out where it like opens up as kind of a hinge. But I've only had the drone for about a day or two now, and I've flown it like 2-3 times, and I have to go like all the way in my front yard, and I've been doing that with this duffel bag. I have everything in it, and my main thing is that it's not protected, and everything's just like fumbling all around there. But with this, you won't have that. Second thing is, because cardboard is not really that protective, get some memory foam from Walmart. Now this thing's like, I'm not even sure how much it is, because my mom had actually picked it up for a school project that I was working on a couple of weeks ago, and I was gonna return it because I didn't even open two of them. But good thing I didn't get to that now, because I got a new project for these. So I've got about three of them here, and I'm not sure how much they were, but I mean, they're definitely not a lot. You get a good 30 by 30 by 5 centimeters, so it should protect it really good. And then scissors. So we're gonna use scissors. Let's get all this stuff out of the way. And now let's open up the bag, see what it's like. It's pretty hard to do on the ground, but it's the only way you can do it. Okay, so in the bag, there's this laptop, very, very thin laptop compartment right there. And then there's this pocket, and then there's a bunch of other pockets. So I know the width must add up to the width of the drone. And so that's why we're gonna actually cut this out. So I was actually cutting it, and I said, why not make a video about it? And so here we are. Go ahead and cut. Pretty easy. gonna keep this for further. I'm gonna keep this part for further, inventions, kind of, because it does have that laptop sleeve, and I think I can make something out of it. But now we've got our expanded bag. Now, I haven't tested this out yet, so if this doesn't work, we need to plan B. Unboxing and the test video out, go check it out. Just click on the channel, it should be there. Let's see if we can fit this on top and close it. If it doesn't fit, it's not that big of a deal. Go ahead and put everything that I need in right now. Alright, so it's not too congested where I can't put any memory foam, but it fits like perfect. And remember, literally all I paid for about this right now was like maybe like $2 for the memory foam. Some of these bags, yeah, they might be pretty expensive, but I just find mine around the house. You can even use suitcases, so small suitcases that you don't use or don't want, keep it if you have a drill. Or just buy a case for the drill. Let's go ahead and put the memory foam in. Okay, so let's see. Empty spaces there. I'm gonna go ahead and stick memory foam in there, but right now I want to go ahead and see if and how the drone fits in here. Let's see, how do I have this? That I got. a lot of you guys might have extra batteries, and I'm considering getting one. Well, actually, I'll show you. Okay, so say there's a battery in the drone already. Hopefully, I don't know what's happening there. But I'll show you guys once I put the battery in. See this little slot? It does fit the drone battery. I don't know if it was meant for that or if it wasn't. But I had realized that. And yeah, that's good. And also, this bag still has a couple of other pockets for me to put whatever I need. And I'm gonna go ahead and put the battery in and show you guys what's like. Okay guys, I just had it face the wrong direction, so the battery goes like that and it works out. But yeah, the battery, it's all in. And guys, that's basically about it. I'm gonna go ahead one more time and try to put this top back on. Or yeah, I'm gonna zip it back up and then I'm gonna try to put the top back on. Half of this, not even actually, it's maybe like around three quarters of that soft foam. It's really, it just depends on the dimensions of what you're actually putting this in. To check out that unboxing and test flight. This should be out in a couple of days. But yeah, subscribe, like.